Janine and Pia, great to have you here.
Thank you for having us.
You look much more glam than when we last saw you on the island.
Do you think?
No offence. Yeah. How is the food today in the glamorous Birdcage tents? How does that compare to what you were swallowing on the island?
As long as they don't give us beans and rice, we're happy.
Was that it, pretty much? Oh,
yeah.
Or we got the odd crab that at full moon, we didn't realise this, full moon crabs used to come and they used to crawl on you. And we used to try and grab them and we used to call it Uber Eats.
So that you'd be asleep and you just feel this thing crawling on you and then you'd just be like, oh. At first you'd be screaming and by the end of the time you're just like, breakfast, and chuck it in the pot.
Kidding.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Blackie, you know, Simon Black, I remember he was trying to catch this crab and I went, be a real man.
Pia, you won Australian Survivor and you won $500,000, is that right? So has that changed your life? What's happened since?
I mean, I think most people know that Australian actors don't really earn very much money, so it's sort of nothing that I ever imagined that would happen to me. So, yeah, it meant more to me than, you know, I can express. I mean, I'm taking the kids to Disneyland in 2 weeks. Wow. And when I left, I said to them, if Mummy wins, I'll take you to Disneyland. And then when I came home, like, when are we going? So, you know, that's something that we would have had to say for, you know, 5-6 years to do. So it's just been amazing.
But it is crawl in there.
Yeah.
Really, and I understand the concept of going to do it because, you know, you're performers, but it's really hard.
There was no performing happening at all. It was, and you know what? But when can you get a chance to really test yourself? What you're made of emotionally, physically, on every level. And I love Pia, and I never would have been able to develop a relationship like that, particularly when you get older, that we have. You know, I see her at least once a week.
Yeah. Oh,
wow.
Yeah. Like,
isn't that nice?
You know, you sort of watch these things and you think it's all fake. But, I mean, we just became so close. And I think we got each other through and we were so excited to, like, it was like when we left, we sort of went to our husbands, I've met someone.
What were you drawn to each other? Because, you know, I'm 38 and I like to say now that I've got my quota of friends. I'm not recruiting anymore. So, you know, finding a great girlfriend later in life can be really hard. What drew you together?
Well, not her body heat. She's only little.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. Like, I mean, Jay would, like, spoon me every night and go, you're going to be okay, you know, when I was crying from the cold. So that stuff will bond you. But, I mean, sometimes, you know, I was the same. I'm 46 and I didn't think I was going to meet any new friends. But we just, you know, met each other and it happened slowly. It took, I mean, slowly on Survivor, it took a couple of weeks. But when we were in it, we were in it, and it was amazing because it's a game about lying. And
did you just like her better than all the other liars?
Pretty much.
We lied to each other, which was really good.
We didn't lie to each other, and we knew, you know, we absolutely trusted each other, which is pretty rare.
I think the reality is we're in this digital world where we're so consumed with our devices more than the people. Mm. And when you're there, you sit in front of the fire, you bond, you talk, and you actually get to know people deeper than you could possibly do outside.
Mm. Have girls taken to Fiji then? You're done with islands. Maybe Vegas.
But have you taken any other tips that, you know, you learned on the island that you've adapted into your life?
Probably gratefulness is probably the biggest thing. I mean, we were talking about on the island gratefulness for flavour, gratefulness for friendship, gratefulness for a door and a window.
Roof and a fridge. I mean, those things are just unimaginable when you're out there.
Correct. Yeah. So it's really about actually appreciating what you have more than anything else. So that was probably the biggest thing.
Yeah, and just it really, I mean, it sounds really sort of out there, but it really connects you to people who don't have anything. You know, we really did feel like we were starving and it's horrendous. We knew we weren't going to die, but it does make you think about...
sometimes.
We felt like... But it does make you think about all the people in the world who, you know, are dying of starvation. Yeah. And that's a really intense thing and it's torture. And so, I mean, you can know about that, but until you've experienced something like it, you really can't...
Losing weight. Everybody goes there and loses weight. Steve Price, I think, lost, you know, 15 kgs.
That was in the jungle.
Oh, that was a different one, wasn't it?
Different one. Apparently the jungle's a walk in the park compared to the island.
So. Eating stuff. Yeah. And, how you couldn't afford to lose weight.
Well, no, I actually didn't realise. You know how you've got a bottom, right? I didn't realise it was padded for seating. So when you lose your bottom, it was just literally bones on dirt. And it's bloody hard.
Yeah, yeah. Jay would be like, Jay would be like, have I lost too much weight? Is it bad? I'd be like, look, it's fine. It's going to be okay.
You said you didn't lie.
True.
It's like when you had that thing on her face. I was going, is that fine?
What's on my face? She's like, just see a doctor when you get home.
So this is a very nice change from being in amongst it on the island. What's the plan for today then?
Like food. You know, we're still fooding up. So food, a little bit of champagne.
Catching up with Abby.
Abby's here, like, from Survivor as well. And Sian.
From season two, who's a divine.
Like, amazing. So we're having a girl Survivor day out. So it's really nice.
And I get the feeling casting directors are looking at you in a whole new light, Pia, when it comes to movie and TV roles. Do you know what I mean? They've seen it the same.
I know, but I feel like people thought I was sweet and I used to get the sweat. And now I'm just going to get the villains. I know it. I know it.
Yeah, but they're the best ones. They're the best ones.
I was going to, bring them on. I'm happy, but yeah, I'll probably get villain roles now.
But that's good. Because women are complicated and complex and haunted and fascinating.
It was fun showing that side of yourself, like the tough side and fighting to win, don't you think? Yeah. Like, I think as women, we, you know, often really push that stuff down and we're sort of taught that we have to be sweet and meek in order to be liked. And so to go out there and just throw that away, I mean, it's tough because people give you, you know, shtick for it, but it's great and it's empowering.
Do you ever want to be isolated again and, you know, being on an island or, you know, in places in the world, junk, whatever, do you ever want to be isolated again?
I liked it.
Yeah, I didn't know.
I like that sort of being in that sort of pocket. What I did love, though, more importantly, is age. And female didn't have any reflection on strength. And so that's what I loved about it. Was what she did with regard to some of the challenges and, you know, the fact that we kept up with these big burly boys was awesome, irrelevant of our age and sex.
Yeah. Well, we loved watching you. Keep your eyes peeled for Australian Survivor All-Stars, which is coming soon to 10 next year. Janine, Pia, keep your shoes on because we don't want you voted out of the Birdcage.
Okay, right? Done.